The United States of America. Can you imagine this country taking orders from a bunch of Islamist, radical, and fundamentalist gun-wielding monkeys? Well, under the presidentship of Joe Biden, that is exactly what the US is doing. It is negotiating with the Taliban. It is giving in to the Taliban's demands. It is making the CIA chief run errands for the Taliban and its mullahs. This is what one wrong choice at the ballot can do. It can destroy a country. And the US's trajectory is anything but motivating as of now. Hi and welcome. This is TFI Global, the foreign affairs and geopolitical analysis arm of the TFI Media Group. I am your host Sanbiran Hotra, and in this video, I will tell you how Taliban is officially holding the Americans hostage and how the US might end up paying ransom to get them released. Let's begin. The United States of America is being held to ransom by the Taliban. American citizens, people from across the world, the US's allies, and those who helped the foreign forces in the 20-year-long inconsequential war in Afghanistan. They are all being held hostage by the Taliban as Joe Biden watches on helplessly and gives in to extremist pressure. In a shocking development, US Central Intelligence Agency, or CIA Chief William Burns, held a secret meeting in Kabul with Taliban co-founder Mullah Abdul Ghani Baradar. Why did the Biden administration have to rush the CIA chief to meet Mullah Baradar, who is set to become the president of the Islamic Emirate of Afghanistan soon? After the meeting, the Taliban reiterated that the United States must be completely wheels up by August 31st. Thousands of foreign nationals, American citizens, and USA troops are still stranded in Afghanistan. And given the pace of evacuations, it is practically impossible for the entire world to complete evacuations by August 31st. Yet, after the meeting between the CIA chief and the Taliban's topmost mullah, Joe Biden attempted to put up a show of confidence once again, saying the withdrawal, which has actually snowballed into a hostile and desperate evacuation campaign out of Afghanistan, will not be extended beyond August 31st. Taliban spokesman Zabihullah Mujahid said the United States should complete its evacuation and withdraw from Afghanistan by August 31st. This date was set by the Biden administration for the withdrawal of all American troops. The Taliban spokesman said his group will accept no extensions to the deadline. While the deadline seems to have been set by the Biden administration, the Taliban is now enforcing it, which points to the direction that the date is not Joe Biden's at all. The Taliban seems to have given the US a deadline of August 31st. Even while the Biden administration says it has set the date for itself. If the latter was indeed the case, why would the Taliban send out warnings to Washington? And why would Washington, despite being fully aware that an entire evacuation is not possible by August 31st, comply with such warnings? The reality is that the Taliban has taken prospective evacuees in Afghanistan as hostages. This has been done to push the United States into a corner. Already, due to the inept leadership of Joe Biden, the US is at its lowest internationally. The fall of Afghanistan to the Taliban has only exacerbated the USA's image crisis. The Taliban is making the journey for evacuees to the Kabul airport extremely difficult. The US in Afghanistan is currently at the mercy of the Taliban. Its evacuation program is functioning only because the Taliban seems to be cooperating. However, this cooperation could be snapped at any moment. The Taliban is dictating deadlines to Joe Biden, and when Mullah Baradar and his compatriots decide enough is enough, they will simply hijack the US and its allies' evacuation efforts. The only reason that has not been done already is because the US has opened political and military channels with the Taliban, and Washington is giving in to the violent extremist organization's demands. Why is it that Joe Biden is insisting on wrapping up evacuation from Afghanistan by August 31st, despite G7 nations and NATO allies reiterating continuously that it is impossible for them to pull all eligible people out of Afghanistan by the given date? The US, the strongest country in the world, the leader of the free world order, and the country which does not negotiate with terrorists, is bending the knee before the Taliban. Joe Biden is taking orders from Mullah Baradar, and nothing could be more shameful. Biden could always, as the commander-in-chief, smoke out Mullah Baradar like Trump bombed the life out of Qasem Soleimani. But old and fragile Joe just doesn't have it in him to do that. Instead, he is putting his country to shame by taking orders from Kabul. He is putting the lives of innocent people in jeopardy by negotiating with the Taliban. What do you think is making the Taliban cooperate in the evacuation campaign? Needless to say, it must be cash, the prospect of getting international recognition, and the promise that the US will not attack the organization ever again. The CIA chief must have landed in Kabul to negotiate the largesse which will be paid to the Taliban as a ransom for its cooperation since August 15. Joe Biden is really taking his country to new lows every day, and there's still 3.5 years of the man left in the White House.